provides for us to preach the gospel and then beg somebody to come to church. That's not the way it's done.
Amen.
The only somebody that can open the door of the church, he opened it 2,000 years ago.
Amen.
And those doors haven't closed yet. And they will not close, because he said the gates of hell shall not prevail against him. He opened them and they will remain open until he come back to receive his church.
Yeah.
I believe that if a person is really ready to come to Christ, they don't care whether I open the door or set the door open, if they're really ready to come to Christ, I feel the Spirit will move them.
Amen.
They're going to get up and they're going to say to the usher or somebody, I'd like to join the church. What can I do? I want to be a part of the church. I'm tired of people coming in and staying here a couple of days and then they're gone. And I see it everywhere I go. I've seen it in revivals. I've seen it all over. You don't have no way of backing up what you're doing, because the Bible doesn't do it. The Bible is our roadmap. It's our guidebook into the kingdom of God. And that's where we're supposed to be on our way, is into his kingdom. But if we're not going to follow his directions, I think we're going to have trouble getting there. And I don't think we're going to be able to accomplish the things that we are setting out to accomplish and the things that we're trying to accomplish unless we're going to put it in God's hand and let it be there. Every week I come here, I see something different. I see something that's amazing. I see something that we've been struggling with ever since I've been here for five or six years. And now it's being done. And you don't have but two men in the church, and that's Brother Clifford and your pastor. And with the help of the women that's helping, and with the prayers that is going up here or there, God is blessing us.
Amen.
And it is time for us to forget about what we don't have.
Mm-hmm.
Just get that out of our mind and think about what we have.
Amen.
Because what we have,
Amen.
If we are sincere,
mm-hmm.
and we are totally committed
mm-hmm.
to being what God would have us to be, don't you fool yourself. God is not going to let us down. God will test us. We are no better than Israel. God tests Israel. Sometimes he had to just back off from them and let them go their way for a while and find out that they couldn't make it without him. And he would do that for us if it come to that point. But we cannot just do things because other folks have a way of doing it and other folks do it. I want to see people come to God because they are truly born again of the Holy Spirit. And there are too many people that we have in the churches that are not born of the Spirit.